morning students. In the last class, we have solved few problems under weighted aggregative or weighted price index number in that weighted aggregative method. So now we will solve few more problems under that where we have solved problems using last year's price index number, past year's Marshall Edwards, Dorbish Boris and Fisher's price index number. Similar kind of problem we will solve in today's class also. So the problem is using the following data. Calculate appropriate price index numbers for the years 2010 and 2011 with regard to base 2005, and the information given are commodity. Next to price in rupees, that is price of 2005, next 2010 and 2011, and lastly quantity, that too in units of 2005. So these are the information provided to you to find out price index number. And commodities are rice, wheat, sugar and the and the prices of these commodities in 2005 is 19, 16, 14 and 16. Whereas prices in 2020, 2010, 24, 21, 22 and 140. Next prices in 2011, 33, 24, 25 and 180. Next, now the quantities in 2005 is given. Quantities are 10, 2, 2 and 1. So this is the information given to you. And you are asked to calculate appropriate price index number. They have not told you which price index number you have to construct. They have told you to calculate appropriate price index number for the year 2010 and 2011. That means both 2010 and 2011 are current years. So for 2010 prices we can take it as P1, whereas 2011 prices we can take it as P2. And with regard to base 2005, that means 2005 is a base year. So base year price is denoted by P0, whereas base year quantity is denoted by Q0. And the information given are base year price, that is 2005 is base year, so P0. Next, current year, first current year is 2010, so P1. Next current year is 2011, so P2. Next, they have given the quantity in units of 2005, that is quantity of base year. So quantity of base year is denoted by Q0. So in which price index number we are going to use the quantity of base year as weight? See, in last year's price index number we are going to use the quantity of base year as weight, because the formula is summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into 100. So Q0 is given. But in past year's price index number we need current year quantity. Q1 is considered as weight. Next, in Marshall Edwards also we are going to use both base year as well as current year quantities. Next, in Dorbish Boris as well as Fisher's price index number we are going to use base year as well as current year quantities as weight. But in Cayley's price index number quantity will be fixed, both for current year as well as but here as current year base year quantity is given, so we are going to calculate last year's price index number. So in the solution we can write it as here 2005 is base year, is the base year, and 2010 and 11 are current years, are current years. Since base year quantities alone are given, so last year's index numbers are computed. So we are going to compute last year's price index number. So for the computation of last year's price index number, first of all we are going to draw the same table once again in the solution part. So the first column is commodity. Commodities are rice, wheat, sugar and dal. Next, you are provided with the information of price of 2005, that is base year prices, denoted by P0. So base year prices are 19, 16, 14 and 16. Next, you are provided with prices of current year, that is 2010. So we can write it as P1. So P1 values are 24, 21, 22 and 140. Next, you are provided with the information of next current year, that is 2011. So we can write it as P2. Prices of second current year, we can write it as P2. So that is 33, 24, 25 and 180. Next, we are given with the quantities of 2005. Quantities of 2005 is nothing but base year quantity, which is denoted by Q0. So the quantities are 10, 2, 2 and 1. Next, now we will write the formula for last year's price index number. So the last year's price index number, last year's price index number for 2010. First we will calculate for the first current year, that is 2010, with respect to base 2010, with respect to the base 2005. Base year is 2005. So the price index number, last year's price index number P01, is equal to summation of P1 Q0 divided by summation of P0 Q0 into 100. So this is the formula. Now first of all we have to calculate P1 Q0. So P1 Q0 means you are going to multiply P1 column with Q0 column. 24 into 10 it is 240. Next 21 into 2 it is 42. Next 22 into 2 it is 48. Next 140 into 1, 140. Now calculate the total. When you make the total of this column, the total is 466. Next you need summation of P0 Q0. So the next column will be P0 Q0. You are going to multiply P0 column with Q0 column. So 19 into 10, it is 190. 16 into 2, it is 32. 14 into 2, it is 28. Next 16 into 1, 60. Now calculate the total. When you make the total comes to 310. Now easily you can substitute the values in this formula. Summation of P1 Q0 is 466. 66 divided by summation of P naught Q naught total is 310 into 100. So when you solve this equation, you will get the answer as 150.32. So this is last year's price index number for the current year 2010 with base 2005. Next, we are going to calculate last year's price index number for the current year 2011. So write it, the last year's price index number for the current year 2011 with base 2005. So last year's price index number P naught 2, because second current year, that's why we can write it as P naught 2 L is equal to summation of P2. We are not going to consider it as P1 because already we have calculated for first current year. Now we are going to calculate it for second current year, next current year. So we can consider it as P2. Summation P2 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into 100. So first of all, we are going to calculate P2 Q0. So that means you are going to multiply P2 column with Q0 column. 33 into 10, it is 330. Next, 24 into 2, it is 48. 25 into 2, it is 50. Next, 180 into 1, 180. When you make the total comes to 608. Next, you need P0 Q0. That P0 Q0 already you have calculated. So now we can easily substitute the values in the equation. So P2 Q0 total, summation of P2 Q0 is 608. 608 divided by summation of P0 Q0. P0 Q0 total is 310 into 100. So when you solve this, the answer comes to 196.13. So you can see that index number has increased from current year 2010 to 2011 by keeping the base year as same, by considering the base year as same, that is 2005. So for current year 2010, last year's price index number is 150.32, whereas for the current year 2011, last year's price index number is 196.13. So like this, you are going to solve the problem when two current years are given and one base year is given, and that two quantities of, if quantities of base year is given, then you are going to calculate last year's price index number. Suppose if quantities of current year is given, then you can calculate past year's price index number. Last year's price index number cannot be calculated because last year's price index number considers the current base year quantities as weight, whereas in past year's price index number we are going to consider current year quantities as weight. If both base year as well as current year quantities are given, then you can calculate Marshall Edgeworth all the five weighted aggregative price index number, that is last year's, past year's, Marshall Edgeworth, Dorbish Wallis as well as Fisher's price index number. But you can't calculate Cayley's price index number because Cayley's price index number considers only fixed quantity as weight, that is base year as well as current year quantities will be fixed. So you can't calculate Cayley's price index number. Now we will solve one more problem. Calculate Cayley's price index number for 2005 from the following data. And the information provided to you are commodities. Next, price in rupees. price in rupees, that is price of 2000 and 2005. Next, quantities. So these are the information provided to you, and you are asked to calculate KLA's price index number. And the commodities are A, B, C and D. And prices of 2000 are 15, 20, 4 and 10. Next, prices of 2005, 22, 27, 7 and 20. Next, quantities are 15.5, 12.5, 7.5 and 7.5. So this is the information where base year price as well as current year price is given. 2000 is base year and 2005 is current year, and quantities is given and they have not specified whether it is base year quantity or current year quantity. That means you have to think that it is fixed. Quantities are fixed for both base year as well as current year. When fixed quantities are given, you can calculate KLA's price index number, or it is also called as fixed weight index number. So to calculate KLA's price index number, first of all we will write that whatever information is given, that is here quantities neither relates to base year nor current year. So the appropriate index number is fixed weight index number, or it is also called as KLA's index number. Now we are going to draw the same column or same table once again. That is, first column is commodities. Commodities are A, B, C and D. Next, we are provided with prices of base year. 2000 is a base year, so prices of base year is denoted by P naught. Now we will write the prices. First 15, 20, 4 and 10. Next, we are provided with prices of current year, that is P1, 22, 27. Next, 7 and 20. Next, we are provided with quantities, that is fixed quantities. So we are going to write it as Q. So Q is 15.5. Next, 12.5, 7.5 and 7.5. Now we are going to write the formula of KLA's price index number. KLA's price index number is P01K is equal to summation of P1Q divided by summation of P0Q into 100. So this is the formula of KLA's price index number. Now first we will calculate summation of P1Q. So to calculate summation of P1Q, first you have to calculate P1Q. So you are going to multiply P1 column with Q column. 22 into 15.5. So it is 341. Next, 27 into 12.5, it is 337.5. Next, 7 into 7.5, it is 52.5. 20 into 7.5, it is 150. Now calculate the total. When you make the total, answer comes to 881. Next, now we will calculate, we need P0Q. So next column will be P0Q. for P naught Q, you are going to multiply P naught column with Q column. 15 into 15.5, it is 232.5. Next, 20 into 12.5, it is 250. 4 into 7.5, it is 30. Next, 10 into 7.5, it is 75. Now, calculate the total. When you make the total, the answer comes to 587.5. Now, we got the value of summation of P1Q as well as summation of P0Q. Now, we are going to substitute the values in the equation or formula. So summation of P1Q is 881 divided by summation of P0Q is 587.5 into 100. So when you divide it and multiply it with 100, the answer comes to 149.95. So this is KLE's price index number, or it is also called as fixed rate price index number. So when quantities are fixed, you are going to calculate KLE's price index number or fixed rate price index number. Here quantities are not specified, whether it is base year quantity or current year quantity. That's why we are going to calculate. If at all, if it is not specified in the question also, you are going to calculate KLE's price index number. So these are the two problems that we have discussed in today's class. Few more problems we will discuss in our next class.